Hello friends, welcome to another Microsoft Fabric video. In today's video, we are going to explore OneLake Explorer. It is not a file explorer only, it is more than that. We're going to take a look at that, how OneLake Explorer can be used and also how does it work. I'm going to show you the article about OneLake Explorer. I already have downloaded it and installed it, and we're going to look into the end-to-end how OneLake Explorer help us to bring our data into Microsoft Fabric. Here is the OneLake File Explorer article from Microsoft, and I will share the link in the blog post. I don't want to go through the whole article, but basically, from this article, I downloaded the File Explorer and installed on my local computer. And once it was installed, of course, it asked me to log in, and I logged in with my Azure Active Directory authentication and all that fun stuff. And then once it is installed, with this, I can actually explore my data on my OneLake. Again, keep in mind, the biggest thing in Microsoft Fabric is OneLake is similar like OneDrive. So basically, you bring your data into OneLake. So once I use OneLake Explorer in the Windows, this is how it look like. So in Explorer, everything just look like in a Windows Explorer or the File Explorer. What we see here is a different folders. What these folders are, basically, it is showing me all the different lake houses what I have on my tenant based on what I'm logged in as. So I have a 4 or 5 different lake houses on my tenant, and which are created in Power BI service. Again, if you watched my previous videos on Microsoft Fabric, we're working on a workspace called FabTUS, and that's what it looks like here because we have a lake house in that. So once I go into FabTUS, what we will see is a different subfolders. All these subfolders are basically showing us the lake house and the data warehouse. I have a FabTUS DWH is a data warehouse, and also I have a FabTUS Lakehouse as the Lakehouse own in under this workspace. So if we go to Lakehouse, what we have further is the files and tables and warehouse system. These are some internal warehouse system, is some internal structure in there. But the main folder which we are interested when we're using OneLake Explorer is files. Basically, what you can do is you can bring your own files here and copy from your different sources on your local drive or from other sources where you have. You can bring your data files into a OneLake Explorer in that particular lake house. I already created a folder called test, and I have a couple of files in there. What I'm gonna do is to create another folder. Let's call it a File Explorer demo. And I'm going to copy the file from my test folder and bring it into File Explorer demo. So keep in mind, I have kept 3 type of files. One is a CSV, one is a JSON, and one is a Parquet file. So I've copied 3 different format files. So how does it look like in Power BI service? Let's go to our Lakehouse where we copy these files and see what happened there. Here in Power BI service, we're gonna go to, I went to my workspace, which is FabTUS, and under that there is a Lakehouse, which is called FabTUS Lakehouse LH. That's where we copied those files. So if we open that FabTUS Lakehouse as our Lakehouse in the Explorer, so what you see is that folder which we created with the OneLake Explorer automatically showed up in the Lakehouse. So this is what it does look like. As you can see, the test is already there, and this one's the new one which we created. And once we go into that particular folder, we will see all the files in there which we copied. Now, what we can do with these files, why we want to copy these files here, the question comes up, we can actually create a tables, a data table, delta tables from these files. So certain kind of formats are supported where you can create those delta tables. So if I go to the CSV file and I go here and I go load to tables, it will automatically, we can create a delta table here, which then further we can use it for in our data set or wherever we need to use it. So let's call it customers. I'm just gonna give it a name, confirm. And it's gonna start loading a table into our Lakehouse. So we will see this table once this loading of the table in progress is finished, we will see that customer table in here as well. And similarly, if we go to Parquet, we have the same option, load to tables. And but if I go to the JSON, this is completed loading. So we should, as you can see, the customers is there. Now, if I look into my preview here, I will see all the data. So basically, without using any data factory, like data pipeline or any other tool, basically, I just copy the file into my OneLake through the OneLake Explorer, and then just loaded it to the table. Again, going back to file format here, not all the file formats are automatically has the option to load as in a table. If I click here, my JSON does not allow me to load in as in a table. Now, only certain formats are allowed to load as table. I hope in the future more formats will be get added to it, but at this point of time, CSV and Parquet, the format which I found, can be loaded as in table. Now, other question comes is like, what else we can do with this? And if we copy the files there, if I cannot load those to the tables, what else I can do? Basically, a couple of things we can use it for. We can create a data flow. Let's do that and use the files from here for our transformation as well. So if I go to data flow 8, probably it's there's nothing in there, and I'm not going to do the transformation here, but basically you can browse the files on your Lakehouse and you can use it for further transformation and load it to your final destination. So if I go here, get data, and I go to more, and if we search Lakehouse here, search for Lakehouse. Okay, here you go. So we have a Fabric Lakehouse beta, and then I already have a connection created, so it automatically loaded that. If I go next, what I will see here is that there are two options, and one of the option you will see, let's first go to our FabTest warehouse. That's where it is. We need to select the warehouse, which Lakehouse we want to use. And then we have a FabTest Lakehouse. If I go in there and open that one, actually, if I expand it, what you will see is we have these tables and then we have a files folder as well. So these tables are which are already loaded as a delta tables. It is ready for us to be consumed in our data flow. But I have a JSON file which I want to transform, for example. Then I will go into the files and you will see this file explorer demo. Sorry, I did a wrong spelling here, file explorer instead of file explorer. But anyhow, so if I go file explorer, expand my folder there, file under files, now I can pick my this particular JSON file and I can use it for the transformation. So basically, if you not necessarily directly loading the tables to the delta tables in the Lakehouse, you can still use this as in a repository for further transformation in your data flow and in the data pipeline as well, basically under data factory any tool. One another question comes in mind is, can I use this in my Power BI as well? So let's take a look, Power BI desktop. I mean, let's take a look at that as well. Okay, so here we have Power BI desktop, and keep in mind, you have to make sure that you're using May 2023 Power BI desktop, because that's when the connector for the Microsoft Fabric was made available. In Power BI desktop, let's go to Data Hub and then pick up Lakehouse Preview. In case you don't see it here, you can go to Get Data and Microsoft Fabric Preview, and you will see Lakehouse under that Microsoft Fabric connectors. So if I pick Lakehouse from here, again, keep in mind everything is in preview in Microsoft Fabric, and it will list all my Lakehouses, the one I have access to. And if I go to FabTest Lakehouse again, this is the one which we are working on. And once we select our Lakehouse from this connector, first of all, as soon as I click on the FabTest Lakehouse, I have multiple options here, connect to the SQL endpoint or connect directly to the Lakehouse. But let's go, we directly connect to the Lakehouse and what happens. So first of all, you will see here, we don't have the option to pick and choose whether we want to connect to the files on the Lakehouse or pick a file from the Lakehouse or a table. Basically, as soon as I connected to the Lakehouse, it automatically loaded all the tables available on the Lakehouse. It basically connected to the default data set on the FabTest Lakehouse, which is automatically get created when you create a Lakehouse or a data warehouse. So this was is like if we choose connect, but let's try again with connect to the SQL endpoint, what happens. But the point here is, when you're connecting from Power BI desktop directly to the Lakehouse, you are automatically connected to the Delta tables available on your Lakehouse, not to the files. You don't have the option for it. But let's try the second option. We have to connect to the SQL Server and what happens there. Okay, here we go. We go Data Hub, Lakehouse Preview. Again, I'm gonna pick up the same Lakehouse, FabTest LH. Once it show up here, FabTest LH, instead of saying connect, I will go connect to SQL endpoint. So once I connected to SQL endpoint, it automatically connected to this, pick up the SQL behind the scenes or the to the SQL endpoint. I assume I will get the option to pick and choose which table I wanted to see here. And here you go. So now I have the ability to pick and choose whatever table I wanted to use, basically creating a now Power BI data set. So because this particular video is more on a OneLake Explorer. So now the question comes is there any cost associated when if I drop my data files onto OneLake? As we know, recently we got the what the fabric is going to cost. And in that particular blog post, I will share the link in the video description of this video. There is an area where it says that OneLake storage also has the cost, extra cost on top of the fabric capacity. Let me quickly show you guys that where it is in the blog post. If you look at the OneLake storage here in the blog post, it says OneLake storage prices is compared to the Azure ADLS, Azure Data Lake storage pricing. For example, the price of US West 2 is 0.02 cent per GB per month. And there will be a transfer rates and all that fun stuff. So you can read the details on the blog post and further look into that. But the point here is, if you're dropping the files on OneLake storage using OneLake Explorer, which makes it very, very easy to bring the files, it has advantages and disadvantages because there is some cost involved in this. So you can't just dump the files and use it as your OneDrive for data. You want to make sure, again, there's an option. You want to use OneDrive for Business, or you want it to be here, and then you can directly load the data into tables in the Lakehouse in certain formats. But again, there is some cost involved. In summary, let's answer a couple of the questions what we've seen in this video. First of all, is there any cost involved in the OneLake storage? Yes, there is a cost. So you want to make sure when you're copying the data in there, all the files you're just copying, you have to make sure that it's going to cost you. The second question comes in mind is, can I change the tenant on this? Say once I'm logged into one tenant, let's say I work as a consultant, I work with the many companies, can I switch between the tenants? Unfortunately, with the OneLake Explorer, the file explorer at this point of time, you cannot switch between the tenants, but I assume that feature will come some point of time. Can the files on OneLake Explorer or in the files in the Lakehouse can be used for other purposes? Yes, we can use it in Dataflow Gen 2 and access those files and in the data pipeline as well, and transform and use it for further analytical purposes. So overall, it makes things very, very easy. Copy the data and bring it to the Lakehouse, and then further use it for at one single place. All your data files are there, and then that's the goal of Microsoft Fabric anyhow, so that the files are not sitting at multiple places. So data files in one place, and then you can use it as per your need. I hope this video give you some ideas about what the OneLake File Explorer is, how it can be used. Let me know what you guys think about it. There is no more Microsoft Fabric videos are in the pipeline. Do subscribe my channel. Until next video, have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Thank you.